Hi, I'm Sebastian Dietal here with the first game show ever for GBurg TV, Bullet Time. Here, we're in Musselman Library with unsuspecting students to ask them physical challenges or maybe a question or two. The winner gets a $1.50 coffee. Here's your host, MJ Roche.
Hi, I'm MJ Roche. Let's go find our first contestant. Hi, I'm MJ Roche with Bullet Time. What's your name?
And score fast.
Would you like to compete for a $1.50 coffee?
Yes, I would.
Now, would you like the intellectual trivia question or physical challenge?
Physical challenge.
Physical challenge it is.
Show me your moves.
Ansgar Fossey, are you ready to compete in Bullet Time?
Yes.
Then let's go. Ansgar Fossey, your physical challenge is bounce the ball into a bucket.
That's it.
Now, where's the ball? You have to take this tennis ball. Behind the book. You must bounce it once into the bucket. Your time limit is?
10 seconds.
10 seconds. Are you ready?
Yes.
At the stroke of the clock, I will say go, and then you must bounce the ball into the bucket. Are you ready?
Yes.
Go! Here we are, on Scarf. He's trying to get the ball. He's running. Almost, he's getting close. Seven seconds. Oh. And the last try. Oh. Here we go, bouncing. Oh. We're very sorry.
It's okay. I'll survive.
Thank you for competing. Hi, I'm MJ Roach with Bullet Time. Would you like to compete in a game show?
Sure.
What's your name?
Andrew.
Now, Andrew, would you like a trivia question, or would you like to compete in the physical challenge?
A trivia question.
Trivia question. In which category? Science, miscellaneous, history, or English?
History?
Okay. All right, Andrew, your history question is, you must name all the United States presidents within 3 minutes, 40 out of 44. Are you ready?
Sure.
Ready, go.
Washington, Adams, Jefferson, Madison, Monroe, Adams, Jackson, Van Buren, Harrison, Tyler, Polk. I need to name them in order, okay. Buchanan, Lincoln, Johnson. Hayes, Grant, Coolidge, Cleveland, McKinley, Taft, Roosevelt, both of them. FDR and Theodore. Coolidge, I said. Harding. Wilson. Hoover. I said FDR. Truman. Kennedy. Eisenhower. LBJ. Nixon. Carter. Reagan. Ford. Both Bushes, GW, and Clinton, Obama. How many am I missing?
You're missing seven.
Seven.
Three.
Seven. Arthur? No, there was not a President Clinton. I mean, yeah, there was a President Clinton, but.
A minute and 15 seconds.
God, I can't. Can you guys help? Yeah. Is that cheating? Tyler or and Taylor. Okay. You can't Pierce.
You're the man now, dog.
I think I made it.
Yep, that's 40. Here we are with Andrew, our first winner in the history trivia question. Here's your prize money. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Let's go find our next contestant. Hi, I'm MJ Roach. Would you like to play Bullet Time?
Yes.
What is your name?
Chaz Andrews.
Chaz, now, would you like a physical challenge or trivia question?
Trivia question.
Now, in which category? English, science, history, or miscellaneous?
English.
English it is. Chaz, you have picked the English question. Your English question is, I will give you the opening line of famous books. You must name the book and the author. You have 4 minutes, and you have to get 13 out of 16. Are you ready?
Yes.
Here you go.
Okay.
All righty. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times.
I recognize the thing, but I believe it's Charles Dickens.
Charles Dickens, and you must name the novel.
Great Expectations.
No, you're allowed to pass.
Pass.
All children except one grow up.
Peter Pan, James M. Barrie.
Correct. It was a pleasure to burn.
Oh, Fahrenheit 451, Ray Bradbury.
Correct. Call Me Ishmael.
Oh, name just went out of my head. Nathaniel Hawthorne.
Moby Dick.
Moby Dick, yeah.
Bye.
I thought it was Hawthorne. No, it's not Hawthorne.
You're allowed to pass.
Melville.
Herman Melville, correct. It was a bright, cold day in April, and the clocks were striking 13.
Pass.
You better not never tell nobody but God.
Catcher in the Rye, Salinger?
No.
No, okay.
Pass. Not so long ago, a monster came to the small town of Castle Rock, Maine.
I've heard it before, but I can't think of it, so pass.
He was an old man who fished alone in a skiff in the Gulf Stream, and he had 84 days now without taking a fish.
Old man in the sea, Hemingway.
Correct. Through the fence between the curled flower spaces, I could see him hitting.
Pass.
124 was spiteful.
Pass.
In the week before their departure to Arrakis, when all the final scurrying about had reached nearly unbearable frenzy, an old crone came.
Pass.
It was a truth universally acknowledged that a single man in possession of a good fortune...
Jane Austen, Pride and Prejudice.
Correct.
I love Jane Austen.
All happy families are alike. Each unhappy family is unhappy in its own way.
No clue.
Mr. and Mrs. Dursley of number 4 Privet Drive were...
J.K. Rowling, and that is Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone.
Correct. If you really want to hear about it, the first thing you will probably want to know is where I was born and what my lousy childhood was like.
Pass. Familiar, but... yeah.
In my younger and more vulnerable years, my father gave me some advice that I've been turning over in my mind ever since.
Pass.
Far out in the uncharted backwaters of the unfashionable end of the western spiral arm of the galaxy lies a small, unregarded yellow sun.
Oh, that is Hitchhiker's Guide to the Universe, Adams?
Correct. All right, I'll go back and give you the author. You must name the book. It was a bright, cold day in April, and the clocks were striking 13. George Orwell.
Oh, 1984.
Correct. If you better not never tell nobody but God, Alice Walker.
No clue.
Not so long ago, a monster came to the small town of Castle Rock, Maine. Stephen King.
Carrie? No. It? No. Well.
Pass?
Pass.
Through the fence between the curling flower spaces, I could see them hitting. William Faulkner.
Oh. Sound of the Fury?
Correct. 124 was spiteful. Toni Morrison.
I have not read anything by her.
In the week before their departure to Arrakis, when all the final scurrying about had reached a nearly unbearable frenzy, an old crone came, Frank Herbert.
Never read anything by him.
All happy families are alike. Each unhappy family is unhappy in its own way, Leo Tolstoy.
That is War and Peace?
No.
Anna Karenina?
Correct. If you really want to hear about it, the first thing you'll probably want to know is where I was born and what my lousy childhood was like, J.D. Salinger.
Oh, that is Catcher in the Rye.
Correct. In my younger and more vulnerable years, my father gave me some advice that I've been turning over in my mind ever since. F. Scott Fitzgerald.
Great Gatsby?
Correct.
You're the man now, dog!
Chaz, congratulations. Here's your $1.50. Enjoy your coffee.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hey, you. There. Hi, I'm MJ Roach. This is Bullet Time. Do you want to compete in a game show?
Yeah.
What's your name?
My name is Xavier.
Now, Xavier, you have two choices. One, you want to do the physical challenge, or do you want to compete in an educational trivia question?
Well, I don't know. Physical.
Physical challenge it is.
Show me a moves.
Xavier, your physical challenge is you have 30 seconds to make Frank laugh. Are you ready?
Well, it's not a physical challenge. That's more of a...
Are you ready?
Yeah, sure.
All right, ready, set, go.
Okay. Do you have kids? Where are you from?
Maine.
You're from Maine? What do you like about Maine?
Nothing.
Nothing? Move to New York. I live in New York. You should move to New York.
No.
I'm going to tell you a joke right now. Two peanuts were walking down the street. One was assaulted.
Wow.
Okay. Okay. That's a nice hat you got there. Do they make it in men's?
You're not doing very well, are
you? Do they make it in hetero? Ooh, tough crowd. Okay. How long have you been working here?
A little more than 30 seconds, like somebody asked
for. How long have you been working here?
5 years.
5 years? I was born 5 years ago.
I believe that.
All right. Do you? You shouldn't. I have facial hair. I have facial hair. I hit puberty like 10 years ago. Man, you are just a tough nut to crack.
Oh, Xavier, I'm so sorry. Thank you for competing.
No problem.
Do you want a hug?
No.
Oh. Hi, my name is MJ Roach from the game show Bullet Time. Would you like to compete in a game show?
Yes.
Okay, what is your name?
Liz.
Hi, Liz. Now, you have a choice. Would you like to do a physical challenge or an educational trivia question?
I'll take the physical challenge.
Physical challenge it is.
Show me a moves.
Right, Liz, you picked the physical challenge. Your physical challenge is you have 15 seconds to blindfoldedly walk a straight line. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right. Ready to get prepared.
Go, Liz, go!
Challenge is beginning. The blindfold is being securely placed around Liz's eyes so she cannot see the line, which she is about to walk.
Liz, you have just won $1.50 to go buy your own coffee. How excited are you?
Really excited.
How hard was it?
It was really hard.
All right. Liz, you have won the physical challenge. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Hi, my name is Andrea Roach, and this is Bullet Time, a new game show. Would you like to compete?
Of course.
Now, what is your name?
Michael.
Michael. Now, you have two choices. Would you like the physical challenge, or you can pick from a smorgasbord of educational trivia questions?
I like trivia.
All right, which would you like? English, science, history, or miscellaneous?
Give me the miscellaneous.
All righty. All right, Mike, your miscellaneous question is I'm going to give you famous foursomes, and you must name them all. Are you ready?
Yes.
You have 2 minutes. Start the clock. Ready? Go. Seasons of the year.
Winter, fall, spring, and summer.
Classical elements.
Classical as in music or classical as in...
Classical as in really old. Like Sophocles.
Plato?
No. You're allowed to pass.
Aristophanes?
No.
Drama? Oh.
A famous band from the 70s.
The Band.
Or 60s.
The Beatles.
No.
Earth, Wind, and Fire.
There was a three.
And Earth. And water.
Correct.
Playing card suits.
Spade. Hearts. Clubs. And the other red one. Spades, hearts, clubs. I play solitaire all the time. Spades, hearts, clubs.
and diamond.
Diamond. Cardinal directions.
North, south, east, and west.
Correct. Mathematical operations.
Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division.
Horsemen of the apocalypse.
I'm the Jewish. There's four of them. Sammy Hagar.
Sammy Hagar. New Testament Gospels.
Why would he know those?
That's I don't.
The first book of
John. Revelations.
The first book of the Old Testament.
Genesis.
Correct. States of matter.
Oh wait. Solid, liquid, gas, and oh my god.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mike.
The answer
was plasma.
Plasma, you idiot.
Can I do the physical challenge?
Physical.
I've been studying so much. I'm like
into a trivias. We're good.
How's your hot chocolate, Sebastian?
Delicious.
A night well spent.